Well, I am a representative painter. I'm representative of abstraction. Just plain. Yeah, I was a representational painter when I was a young artist, and I'm a trained figure drawer. And that's how I started out. I'm one of the few people in America who still worked his way through figurative stuff into abstraction. I've done that journey. Well, the first piece of art that I made was made with plaster of Paris. And it was made in a rubber mold. And I had the Virgin Mary, Mary Magdalene, because I went to Catholic school and I'm from an Irish milieu. And the other one that I had, who was the same size as Mary Magdalene, was a rabbit. And I used to make them, and when they would come out of the mold without bubbles in them, perfect, then I was extremely happy. But I remember it was always very difficult to get them out of the mold. Of course, my parents didn't tell me about Vaseline. And then I would paint them, and then I would marry them. So when I'd married the Virgin Mary with her rabbit boyfriend, I would say that the artwork was complete. I would say it, like all artists that endure and develop and evolve, it should be the journey from the given to the to be given. So in other words, when you start out, you're given information, because nothing comes out of nothing. And my work has gone from being quite linear to very much a question of the body. Well, my artistic training was of paramount importance, because when I've gone through my life and I've faced moments of difficulty, how to continue, there's no doubt in my mind that the options I have as an artist, as an artisan and an artist, it's an elevated form of artisanship, come from my training, because I have the ability to think my way through and work my way through. I think right now it is especially important. You can do things in a moment of rebellion, let's say. Like, for example, the Sex Pistols, one of them couldn't play the guitar, and that added to the temporary, let's say, very temporary, charm of the music, which has in fact not escaped its time. It's a perfect example of what I'm talking about. And the issue of craft, knowledge, and the philosophical understanding of why things are the way they are, why they're done the way they are, and what they're supposed to represent, is a consequence of training. You can only get it that way. Well, yeah, there are a lot of painters. And of course, I'm from the generation that moved from the working classes into rock and roll and blues, through blues, the appropriation of blues and folk music into rock and roll. So all of these things have influenced me, but to say it quick, in terms of painting, it goes through the history of Western art, principally, which is very much a question of the development of a surface, I would say. And that includes Cimabue, Raphael, Velázquez, Ribera, Monet, Manet, and so on. Yeah, I have I have three pieces of art up in the front of my building, in my lobby of my studio. One is an Aboriginal painting by Dorothy Napingara. She paints salt lines, very dry work. I went nuts over the Aboriginal artists when I was in Australia and spent significantly more money than I should have. And then there are some performance artists that I like Anna Mendieta. And I love the work of Agnes Martin, but I think people would probably imagine that I would. It's a very different sensibility, of course. She's like a puritanical linear artist, and I'm a sensual body artist. But how surprising that is to people, I don't know. I'm not sure. People are surprised when I tell them what my favorite book is, which is Out of Africa by Karen Blix and Isaac Dinesen. People always seem to be surprised. I don't know why. My first favorite book was The Scarlet Pimpernel, but that was the first book I ever read when I was 16. I didn't read a book till I was 16.